get a cheesy stop with this cheesy defensive strategy. Coming up next. Hey, this is Full Game Prometheus, the only YouTuber that actually gives you full games of all the tips and schemes I post on my channel. I'll show you the good, the bad, and the ugly. So guys, if you're new to my channel, make sure to hit the subscribe button. Also, that notification icon so you can never miss an upload. So guys, I want to go ahead and jump into some more defense. This is going to be out of the 43 defense. In particular, is going to be the 43 over. And this defense is a defense that you can use maybe once in a game, maybe twice. But it's a different defensive strategy that you can go ahead and use against your opponent and basically get a quick stop against them and get them in a situation where they have to punt. Good time to use this is probably going to be right in the very beginning of the game, their first possession. You can get a quick stop and actually get the ball back, or it might be something you might want to flip into in the second half to go and get a stop, but it really depends on how you want to use it. You cannot spam this defensive strategy. It was not going to work. Any smart player, anybody that's actually that knows how to play the game, they're going to shred you if you use this defensive strategy. So you want to use it once, and that's probably about it. I wouldn't jump into it any further than that. So guys, I want to talk about basically using the engage eight is one of your base plays you're going to call. Now it has to be complemented with another play to make it more effective, because it's going to be able to catch your opponent off guard, because usually what happens is when you use the engage eight, you'll get a quick blitz or a quick pass defense, and then all of a sudden they're going to no huddle and try to go ahead and try to attack you again, and you want to flip change it out. So what I like to do is I like to just basically go ahead and call. I like to take my audible for the Mike Will blitz. I'm going to switch the Mike Will blitz out with the Sam Will blitz. Sam Will blitz, and it's because who I'm going to be using, and this will basically catch your opponent off on the next time you snap the ball. So we're going to come out of the engage eight and then set up a blitz from there. So basically, this is a blitz. You're going to have the safety that's going to actually come down into the edge. And what we're going to do is we're going to take our defensive line, we're going to shift them off to the right, and then we're going to take our linebackers and shift them off to the right. Defensive line off to the left, and we're going to go ahead and use this guy right over the middle of the field, and try to go and hover over that center. Now, as you can see, I'm sending basically seven people come in there, and the CPU actually thinks that you're going to be sending eight. And what we're going to do is we're just going to use her over the center, and you can see the pressure just comes in hot. You're going to have a double A gap regardless of where they're going to be at. So let's just go and show this to you in instant replay. You can see the pressure just coming in, and basically with that, you're going to have a massive pressure in there, and you're just going to go ahead and attack your opponent. Now, if he blocks a running back, it doesn't make much of a difference. The running back is not going to pick this up. He's probably going to mass protect. Even if he max protects, you're still going to get, you can see there's three people coming in. So even with the max protects, you're still going to get another person in. It just makes it a little bit harder for you to cover all that territory with basically the coverage. But it's very easy to go and get the pressure. Now, the key to this is actually switching it up when they no huddle. So what we're going to do is we're going to switch into Sam Will Blitz, which is a man version of it. We're going to base a line. We're going to take our line and shift them off to the right. And we're going to give them the same type of look like this. Now, why this is going to be important is that basically what this is going to do is it's going to put you in a situation where he might think he's going to no-huddle you really quick. But now you've got more pressure coming in against him, and he's going to start seeing everybody falling into man coverages. So that's why this defensive scheme works pretty well, is that just as quickly as you still send six again, and then you're going to be using the middle of the safety or the center, so that's actually going to cause some issues. And you just go ahead and chase after your man assignment right there. As you can see, these guys, every single player in this is all locked up. Every single route is locked up. They've got people over the edge. So unless he blocks seven, basically that means that these guys are just completely locked up, and it's going to basically give yourself a good opportunity. So guys, I want to show you me using this. I've actually got a couple videos you'll see shortly of me using this actual defensive strategy on live. It does get me some turnovers, but the one thing is you just can't spam this big of this defensive strategy with using an engage eight, and then the second play would be using that Mike blitz, because what's going to happen is your opponents will pick up your tendencies, they'll max protect and all that kind of stuff. So that's what I recommend. Is I just recommend just doing it once, maybe one series, either the first half or the second half, just to go ahead and catch your opponent off guard and get them in a long third and long and a fourth and long type of situation where they got a punt. So once again, my subscribers, thanks for support, guys. If you do like these type of tips, make sure you smash that like button.